So, what's up? What has been going on? I'm going to document one of my practice runs of Demonic Hordes of Alien Vendetta, and I'm going to show off, I'm going to describe what this map's going to feel like a little bit later on into this run. So let's get started. Right. You'll see how this map goes as we head deeper in. So we first have to clear out a couple of... enemies. Right, so we see a horde of barons and a cyber demon. So we'll hit this door, get the cyber demon out of its cage. Go for the plasma rifle. And look, that's a horde of barons of hell. We want to get the enemies to infight right here. And you'll see, more enemies will start to teleport in. We want to get in there quickly. And I appear to be freezing. Because I accidentally pressed the key. Right, this is a huge horde of enemies. And I'd like to describe my feelings in this map a little bit later on. To see why I'm using it as kind of a template. So once you go back in here, you want to start some infighting. You want to start infighting. And pay attention to the monster count. Now we'll jump in the teleporter. And gather up the ammo. Now this is the reason why I'm using this map as a template. Whoa-ho-ho-ho! Whoa-ho-ho! This map, I'm using it as kind of a template because this has hordes of revenants that are trying to block me and try and surround me. but you want to go into hiding. But this is the average day on a January sales. And this is why I've been using this map as a template. But yes, this is a horde of revenants. Yeah, it's a bit like having a demonic horde of shoppers lining up and going to January sales. And this is a reference to this map. And another reason why this map is full of cyberdemons. And I don't want the cyberdemon. But yes, I have been using cyberdemons a lot as a ploy in several English pieces of writing. I have been using cyberdemons. Yep, because he is a formidable enemy. Whoa, cyberdemon, you're dead. Right, I want to go back and check on progress back here. Whoa. Yeah, I should have gone for the megasphere. And there's an archfire, just to add to the fun. I want to save one of the megaspheres, actually. Get the super shotgun out. I might grab one of the invulns. Shoot the doors. Right, let's go for this. And this is the scene when shoppers go inside the store. Yeah, this place seems to be full of demons. That switch. And oh wait, a horde of cacodemons. This is a mess of enemies. And you don't have a BFG to work about. I need to stop missing my shots. But that's a horde of cacodemons. I might have to take a megasphere. Don't I? And there's two archfiends, from what I know. It's just hard to see their corpses. Now we have to go get the blue key. And I know why is this hard. I'm not gonna get secret one because that one has a megasphere. I've hit the switch, that's great. You don't get a BFG until you get the blue key, so Your main goal is to clear out the enemies with a weapon that is as powerful as you can. Right, now we have to get the shells and go open up the blue door. It's just chain gunners are wandering aimlessly. Right, we can get the BFG, but we gotta that switch first. What we want to do is quickly, because there's enemies teleporting in. Oh, and I haven't grabbed the BFG yet. I'd like to hang around in a safe spot. Not to mention, there's also hordes of imps up on these ledges. And I don't want to use There's demons trying to surround me. I might have to get secret too. But much of the demon horde has been cleared out. It's just demons everywhere. Might as well get secret too. I might want to save up a little bit of rockets. But yes, there are hordes of imps. And I'd like to clear it out from here. Whoa. Imps like to catch me out. Right, because there's not really much, I might as well shut off the recording and finish up the practice, so see you next time. Bye.
Thank you.